depending when you're watching this, welcome to St Mellitus Online. It is so lovely that you've joined us. Whether this is your first time watching or you watch us every week, it is really great to have you with us. So I'm Lucy.
I'm Stu, and together we help to lead St Mellitus in Hanwell, and it is so good to have you with us this morning. Later on our service, Jerry is going to be speaking for us as we journey through this letter to the Philippians in the New Testament. And Philippians is this book which is kind of full of joy. Paul is who writes, it's full of joy despite his circumstances. And so I was wondering, Lucy, what is bringing you joy at the moment?
What's bringing joy is the fact that some of the restrictions have lifted. We went to stay with my sister this week. She lives in the New Forest, if you're watching, hello. And it was so nice to just see her in person, and we were able to stay the night and it was allowed, and that was great.
So tell us, what's bringing you joy at the moment? Yeah. Are you embracing a little bit more freedom, or perhaps I know some of you in the next week or so are looking forward to that. What are you able to do now that you weren't able to do that's really great for you and exciting for you? I think for me this week, actually, something very simple has been really lovely and brought me joy is sitting out in my garden in the sun, and we've got a new deck that's just been built, and it's been lovely just sitting out there reading and chilling out there.
Definitely joy.
Yes. We're going to worship together this morning and fix our eyes on Jesus, hear from his word, pray together. So to kick us off, why don't you pray for us, Lucy, as we come to worship this morning.
Jesus, will you come? We thank you so much that you're with us, wherever we are in the country or world, Lord God, that we can gather together. We just worship you now in spirit and truth in our homes. Amen. Let's worship God together.
Praises rising, eyes are turning. We find
It's now time for our family song. So come on up you get, whether you're watching us in your bed, in your pyjamas, off the sofa. Stu, that's you as well. Come on up we get. Come on. We're going to worship God together. It's really exciting. So let's get the wiggles out. Come on, tinies and tots, show Stu how it's done. Let's shake our hands. Let's give our feet a little wiggle. And we're ready. Let's worship God together now.
I could hike for miles and miles up the biggest mountainside. Swim far across the ocean, I'd never find a place to hide. I could get in a great big sports car and win the longest race. Or even ride on the fastest rocket into outer space. But Jesus, you're never far away ever, because you love us so. You know all about everyone ever, and you love us so. You came all the way, whoa. You came all the way, whoa. From heaven to earth, because you love us so, whoa. Be on a roller coaster whizzing round and round, or zoom in off on a tube train tunnel deep under the ground. Dive right down in a submarine to the bottom of the sea. Fly up high in an aeroplane, but you won't lose sight of me. No, Jesus, you're never far away ever, because you love us so. You know all about everyone ever, and you love us so. 'Cause you came all the way, whoa. You came all the way, whoa. From heaven to earth, because you love us so, whoa. You're never far away ever, because you love us so. You know all about everyone ever, and you love us so. 'Cause you came all the way, whoa. You came all the way, whoa. From heaven to earth, because you love us so, whoa.
So as you all know, especially if your family's with children, it's the summer holidays now. I know that doesn't always feel so different, except there's no timetables to learn. Great. Just to say, our family worship that we put on YouTube for families and children is still happening through the summer. Summer Sundays, we're calling it. We're joined with St John's and St Paul's, and there's some messy games in there and a bit of extra summer fun. So do tune in. It's on the YouTube channel this morning, and it will be uploaded every week as usual throughout the summer holidays.
One of the things we're really excited about next week is we won't be having an online service, but we're going to be joining with thousands of people around the country, around the world, for the New Wine online service. That's going to be at 11 o'clock next week. That's part of the New Wine online festival, which is happening from Thursday through to
Thursday
Monday
evening through to Monday morning.
And there's loads of exciting stuff on there for all kinds of talks, seminars, things to equip us in our faith, to help us grow. So don't tune into St Mellitus next week, but go to New Wine website. There are details somewhere on the screen somewhere about how to do that. Lucy, you're going to tell us a little bit about the children's
Yes,
and
it's
work.
Not just for grown-ups. They've got an amazing programme for children and young people, and you don't have to camp this year. You get to do it from the comfort of your own home. That does bring me joy, not having to camp in the rain, not going to lie. So if you've never been to New Wine and you've got children, I just want to say our children love new wine. They come back really full of faith and ready to really follow Jesus because they suddenly see that they're part of hundreds of other children who know Jesus too. And you get to do that from the comfort of your own home. 9 o'clock every morning, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, there is a children's program like you can watch, and there's worship, there's space cadets this year. It's going to be really great. And they've also, I've got my phone in my pocket, if you have a phone with a smartphone, you can download the New Wine app, and there's a children's app with games and stuff. Just go to the New Wine website. It's supposed to be really amazing, and they'll tell you more about it. And not only children, that's aimed at up to age 11, also 11 plus, called Luminosity. If you go to Luminosity, no, it's not. We are Luminosity.org. We are Luminosity.org. It's the new youth movement from New Wine, and 11 to 18s are covered. There'll be worship, talks, seminars, everything you want for young people to watch and get stuck in to know more of Jesus.
So do check that out next weekend. We'll be back on the 10th of August for our usual online service. We're going to continue now. We're going to have our prayers and our reading, and then Jeremy's going to speak for us.
Let's pray.
Lord Jesus, as we come to you now in prayer, we pray for the advance of your gospel. We thank you that your good news changes lives and it changes our destiny. We thank you that your good news brings hope and healing. We pray for Hanwell and for the borough of Ealing where we live, and we pray for teachers and pupils on holiday. We pray that you'd give them rest. We pray especially for Christian teachers, that you'd refresh them, give them all they need, feed them over this time so they can go back and continue to be salt and light on their return to schools. We pray too, Jesus, for those who are still shielding in our community. We pray that you give them wisdom as they think about the way forward for themselves in their own circumstances. And we pray that you protect them from illness and help them with loneliness. We pray for those people who are shielding who don't know you yet. Bring them close to you. And even if they don't know any Christians, we pray that you would witness to them by your Holy Spirit and speak to their heart. We pray too for those in our local authority. We pray you'd help them to continue to do a really good job for us. We pray that you'd help them to make good decisions, especially in this time where they're short of resources. And we again pray for Christians there to walk with you, to work with integrity, and to witness to you in all that they say and do. We want to think more widely as well, and we pray for our friends and relatives across the UK and abroad who don't yet know you. We pray that you'd help us to be good news to them, and also to bring good news to them. Help us to be bold in sharing our faith with them. We pray for our democracy in the United Kingdom after the report on Russia has been released. We pray that you protect all that is good in our country. We pray that you bless our MPs and you bless our security services. Give them all they need to serve us. Lord Jesus, we pray too for the situation in China, where news is coming out about slavery in farms and factories and of prison camps, even where cotton is produced. We pray that you bring your light into this situation. We pray that you bring your justice, and we pray you bring freedom for those who are oppressed. More than that, we also pray that you provide witnesses to share the gospel to those who are in the middle of this. And we know your love and care is for each one, even in dark places. Jesus, thank you that you are our Lord and Saviour. Give us each the confidence and boldness in you that we need to speak out and share your good news this week. Amen.
Our reading is taken from Philippians chapter 1, verses 12 to 26. To live is Christ. I want you to know, my brothers, that the things that have happened to me have really helped the progress of the gospel. As a result, the whole palace guard and all the others here know that I'm in prison because I'm a servant of Christ. And my being in prison has given most of the brothers more confidence in the Lord, so that they grow bolder all the time to preach the message fearlessly. Of course, some of them preach Christ because they are jealous and quarrelsome, but others from genuine goodwill. These do so from love, because they know that God has given me the work of defending the gospel. The others do not proclaim Christ sincerely. but from a spirit of selfish ambition. They think that they will make more trouble for me while I'm in prison. It does not matter. I am happy about it. So long as Christ is preached in every way possible, whether from wrong or right motives. And I will continue to be happy, because I know that by means of your prayers and the help which comes from the Spirit of Jesus Christ, I shall be set free. My deep desire and hope is that I shall never fail in my duty, but that at all times, and especially just now, I shall be full of courage, so that with my whole being, I shall bring honor to Christ, whether I live or die. For what is life? To me, it is Christ. Death then will bring more. But if by continuing to live, I can do more worthwhile work, then I'm not sure which I should choose. I am pulled in two directions. I want very much to leave this life and be with Christ, which is a far better thing. But for your sake, it's much more important that I remain alive. I am sure of this, and so I know that I will stay. I will stay on with you all to add to your progress and joy in the faith, so that when I'm with you again, you will have even more reason to be proud of me in your life in union with Christ Jesus. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Good morning. My name is Jeremy, and along with Margaret, we support Stu and Lucy as they lead the congregation here at St Mellitus. I wonder whether you've ever found yourself in a situation where something's happened which has caused you disappointment, but when you've looked back over a longer period of time, you can see how things have actually worked out for the best. Some years ago, Margaret and I were trying to move house, and eventually we sold the house that we were living in, but by that stage, the house that we hoped to purchase had been sold. We tried to buy another couple of properties, but that didn't work out, so we ended up moving into rented property for a while, until eventually we found a house that we were happy to move into. We'd only been in that house a couple of weeks when we realised it felt more like home than the house we had lived in for 14 years. It was a really good and positive experience. Today we're continuing looking at Paul's letter to the church in Philippi. And last week on the bulletin, in introducing the series, Stu said, "The theme of knowing joy in all circumstances runs all the way through Philippians. Paul is actually in prison when he writes this letter, but in many ways, if you didn't pay close attention, you'd never know it, because again and again he talks about joy and rejoicing. It actually features 16 times in 104 verses. I don't know about you, but I think if I was in Paul's position, then I'm sorry to say, but joy and rejoicing wouldn't feature so commonly. He's in prison, he's in chains, and yet he is full of joy. And I want to make three brief points about this. Firstly, we are not Paul. I think there's a danger sometimes when we look at how Paul and others respond. We can feel downhearted, disappointed, and yet God doesn't want us to be Paul. Paul had to be Paul, and Jeremy has to be Jeremy. But Jeremy needs to be the best version of Jeremy that he can be. And I have to tell you, I've got a long way to go before I get remotely close to that situation. Secondly, Paul knows the end of the story just as we do. We know that we can look forward as Christians to life after life here on earth. And Paul is so positive about that that he actually says, "I'd sooner go and be with Jesus right now if that's okay, but I think for your sake I'd better stay around a bit longer." And as far as we can tell, he stayed around for a couple of years. But we know the end of the story, and that's something that can give us a confidence and a joyfulness, no matter how hard life might be for us at the present. And then the final point is that even with all the challenges around the pandemic, we still have much to thank God for. Having said that, I know the challenges we face can often feel overwhelming. Margaret and I have certainly found that we tend to be more emotional, we tend to be reacting more to situations we face that in the past wouldn't have had any impact on us. Indeed, a little while ago, for a day, I felt almost overwhelmed because everywhere I looked, in every situation I was involved with, there seemed to be a challenge. Now, normally I'm somebody who thrives on challenges and gets excited about facing them. But there was this period when I thought, this is really tough and difficult. And maybe many of you can identify with feeling like that during this time. But I have to tell you that the challenges I faced were nothing compared to the situation that Paul was facing in Philippi. There he was in prison. But in verse 12, he says, I want you to know, my friends, that the things that have happened to me have really helped the progress of the gospel. You hear that? The things that have happened to me have really helped the progress of the gospel. He was concerned about what was happening in the church at Philippi. He was worried that maybe as he wasn't around, they'd become disheartened. But he had reports back that because they'd heard about what was going on for Paul, they'd actually been encouraged. And what was going on for Paul? He was talking about Jesus. With every new group of guards that came along, they were stuck with him for several hours at a time, and Paul would talk to them about Jesus. Then the guards would change, another group would come, they'd sit with him for some hours, Paul would talk about Jesus. So there were huge opportunities for Paul to talk about Jesus. And this encouraged him and encouraged the church outside. If Paul was doing that, then maybe they could continue to do the things that Paul has suggested they should do. But what about us today? What has been the effect of the pandemic on the church? Well, clearly it's had a dramatic effect in that although we can now meet back in the church building, we can't sing, we can't have refreshments, we can't spend time afterwards building our relationships with each other and with God. But what's interesting, although that is the case, and you might have thought that might have a negative impact on involvement with church, TearFund did a survey recently of 2,000 adults, and they found that 24% of those surveyed had looked online at a church service. And that compares with about perhaps 11% of the population who normally would go to church. And 5% of that group, 1 in 20, were people who had never been to church before, and yet they were engaging online. And so God is still at work doing things through the church community. Bill Hybels has said the local church is the hope of the world. And it is challenging to work out how we can be the hope of the world in the community of Hanwell at this time. How can we individually as a church show love and hope to those we encounter? Paul showed huge courage in the way he responded to the challenges he faced. He encourages us to rejoice. So what might God be wanting us to do at the present time? Maybe we need to ask God. And it takes courage to say to God, okay, what are you calling me to do at this time? But it also then takes courage to take the first steps forward into what we believe God is calling us into. But my prayer is for all of us, that we would know the presence of the living Lord Jesus in our lives at all times and in all circumstances. And that we would be able to rejoice, because even when we cannot feel it, we know that God is with us in all circumstances. We know the end of the story. We know there is hope and a future. And so may God bless, protect, and encourage us all this day and in the days ahead. Amen.
deep cries out to you.
Yes, Lord, that's our prayer this morning, that in our homes, you would come afresh. Lord, we say that we need you. Lord, would you, as it were, come like a spring rain upon dry land, or where we're dry and perhaps weary, would you bring your refreshing and your life? Where we need fresh strength and energy, would you bring that to us? Lord, where we need to know that you are with us in the midst of all the challenges, would you come?
Mm.
Just encourage you now, just to wait. We're going to wait for a moment, just in our homes, in wherever we are right now. It's as we wait, he comes, as we give him time. So it's just, we're just going to pause for a moment, have a little bit of quiet, a little bit of stillness. And I want to just encourage you to maybe just to stretch out your hands as a posture that I've wanted to receive almost from the Lord this morning, what he wants to give to you. So, Lord, we pray that ancient prayer, a prayer prayed by your followers for thousands of years. Come, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord God.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Lord Jesus. We've got a plant behind us, and I'm not good with plants, but this plant's amazing because when it's too dry and needs a drink, it rolls up all its leaves. And then when you water it, all the leaves come undone like a... And I just feel like there's people watching where your leaves are all rolled up and you just need God to fill you again. So in this moment now, just ask him, just say, come, Lord Jesus, come. Lord, those who are feeling dried up and weary, will you just water them afresh right now? As we say in times of touch, from our head down to our toes, God loves me. Lord Jesus, from your people's head to their toes, will they be filled afresh with your Spirit?
I just wonder whether some watching this morning, the word that keeps going through my head is forgotten, and you feel like you've been forgotten. Whether by God or by others. But the truth is that God never forgets. The scripture says that our names are written on his hands. And I think, believe that just in this moment as we wait in our homes, that God wants to pour his love afresh into your heart, the knowledge that you are not alone. He's not forgotten you. He is with you.
Yeah.
So, Lord, we pray. Lord, we won't just want to know about you. We want to know you, to experience your love and your presence. Pour your Spirit out afresh, we pray.
I've just had a picture of a child at a kind of appropriate age where, as a parent, you're teaching them how to light a match for the first time. and the child's really frustrated because they're like, I can't quite do it. You know, when it starts to spark, but it won't light the match. And then the parent's like, it's okay, you're doing really well, but let me help you. And together, when they hold hand, they strike it and it lights up. And I feel like that's a picture of God and us. We're the child and God's that parent. And you're feeling like, I want to be able to have joy. I want to have that sense of joy. But actually, like, you can't do it on your own. We make a choice and God will light that flame. That God just wants to say to some people that I'm going to light the match with you and spark that joy in you afresh.
Just encourage you to keep receiving from the Lord this morning. We're going to sing a final song now, just as we respond to what God's doing in our hearts. But perhaps, you know, something that resonated, click with you this morning. If that's the case, do get in touch. We'd love to pray with you over the phone, over email, however it comes, that you would know God's presence and power at work in your life. Let's sing together now as we put our focus and attention on the God who loves us and who pours his love into our hearts.
All my days I will sing this song of gladness, give my praise to the fountain of divine. Oh,
So friends, we're coming to the end of our time together now. It's been so good to have you with us. Thank you for joining us this morning. Don't forget, we've got a Zoom call coming up after the service, a great opportunity to catch up with friends, make some new ones.
Yep.
Details of how to join that are in our news sheet. Let me pray a final prayer of blessing now. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and give you his peace. And so may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and all who you love and care for and pray for this day and evermore. Amen.
Amen. Don't forget, next week we're not here. There won't be on YouTube. We won't be here. New wine next week. Tune in with thousands of others. We will be. And we'll see you at St. Mellitus the week after online.
Take care, everyone. God bless.
Bye.